with a word of prayer and turn everything over to him. And this is Brother Emmett Schakel.
Are you guys with me, please, real quick? Heavenly Father, we come before you today and give you all our praise and thanks. We ask that you bless the food we receive, the nourishment of our bodies. I pray, God, that you will watch over every single person in this room right now. Watch over their friends, watch over their families, every single name and number in their contact list. Cover them in your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Good morning, good morning. Thank you so much for having me. Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, there we go. There we go. Check the temperature. Thank you so much for having me. My name is Emmett Schakel, and I wanted to share some things with you today. What arrives before you get there and after you leave? Answer, character. Character is so important, ladies and gentlemen. Character will put you in places where money can't. Does that make sense so far? Oh, I see what's going on here. I gotta wake you up. So we're having breakfast. Anybody care for some bars with their breakfast? Not monkey bars, not breakfast bars, bars. E equals MC squared, like a test. I got them boys scared. Spit flames with no practice. Common sense is not common practice. I keep count like an abacus. More precision than a mathematician as I triangulate on your position. My flow is deep like rivers underground. We awake now? Okay, all right. That's the temperature. Character is very vital, it's important. So I need you to stay focused. Three things we're going to talk about. Stay humble, treat your friends wisely, and last and final thing is impact. Impact is key. When it comes to your character, right now, right here, you are in the formative years. Say formative.
Formative.
Parents, teachers, preachers. They're going to shape you into the man and woman you're destined to be. They're going to alter your trajectory. Does that make sense? Thank you. So I need you guys to make sure that you remember every single day. It counts. Raise your hand if you actually saw the NCAA championship, the women's, Iowa versus LSU. Anybody see that game? I didn't see it, but I heard a lot of talk about it. A lot of talk from the critics. And some of the critics, they said a lot of things that didn't seem all that important. They focused on two people, Angel Reese and Caitlin Clark. And it's funny because some of the people that had all the stuff to say never played basketball a day in their lives. But they had a whole lot to say. So I said, wow, that's crazy. Here's the thing that you need to remember about that championship, okay? Yes, trash talk is part of the game, I get it. But here's something very vital, very important. Trash talk is a choice, it's a decision. You decide if it's part of your game. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. Okay. So when it comes to trash talk, a bad day will humble anyone. A bad day will humble anyone. And if you play the game long enough, you will have a bad day. I don't care who it is or what sport, pick them. It doesn't matter. Michael Jordan, Tiger Woods, Roger Federer, Ronda Rousey, Kobe Bryant, LeBron James, Steph Curry, pick any of them, and they've all had a bad day. So you gotta make sure that you understand that moving forward, okay, guys? So when I say stay humble, it's not easy. It's not easy to stay humble. It's a challenge. You have to have that wherewithal, that energy and that focus, that when you're tempted by the enemy to say or do something, that you have that calm and restraint not to do something that you could regret later. Everybody in here is a student athlete. Say student athlete.
Student athlete.
Everywhere you go, everything you do, you represent Pine Tree. You represent your mom, your dad, your friends and family. Make them proud. Hold your head up, your chest out, and bring honor to the name of your family and to this community. This is what's called a culture. Say culture.
Culture.
This is what's called a culture. The culture will tell you what is right and what is wrong. Because when you have scouts coming to see you, they're going to look at your performance. On the court, yes. On the football field, yes. On the baseball diamond, yes. They're going to look at that. They're also going to look at other key factors. What does this do? What does this person do off the field? How are their grades? Do they do any volunteer work in the community? Do they go to church? They're going to look at those things because they have to make sure that before they give you that contract and that scholarship, that you align with their cultures and their beliefs. Point number two. Anybody remember what point number one was? Stay humble. All right? Point number two, guys. Choose your friends wisely. Choose your friends wisely. Anybody see that last Doctor Strange movie? Yeah, you saw it? Yeah. The director and one of the actors in that movie, best friends for decades. Best friends. Every single movie that that director has made, he has a card in that movie. Every single movie he's ever made, it has the same card in it for 20-something years. They were best friends, and they're still doing their thing to this day. LeBron James, look at his friends. Where are they now? When his friends were 18 and 19, they were just like you, hanging out, having fun. Now look what his friends do. LeBron James doesn't manage his deals. His friend manages his deal. Gatorade, any kind of movie deals, any sponsorship, any of those contracts, his friend does it. Why? How? That doesn't make sense. He's just a friend. Here's what happened. LeBron James was successful and decided to make sure his friends could take care of him. So he paid for his friend to go to school, and now his friend has a degree, and his friend is able to negotiate million-dollar contracts and sponsorships for the rest of his life. Your friends will take you up in life, or they'll take you down in life. I'll say that again. Your friends will take you up in life or down in life. Raise your hand if you heard of Kevin Hart. You heard about his friend? Guy that tried to steal all that money from him? Guys, sometimes you have to upgrade your friends. Sometimes your parents will say, I need you to stop hanging around this girl or this boy. Sometimes parents are not perfect. Sometimes they get it wrong. But sometimes they see things that you can't. My mom and dad was the same way. They warned me. I was like, nah, it's okay, it's cool, it's cool, it's cool. It ain't gonna happen to me. I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna do that, mom. Where are some of those friends now? Just like my mom and dad told me. Some of them are no longer here anymore. Some of them are incarcerated. But I didn't listen. Because when I was your age,
yeah, it's all good. It's cool, it's cool, it's cool, it's cool.
But they were right all along. Raise your hand if you know what a healthy friendship is like. Okay? Give me some words to describe a healthy friendship. Anybody? Don't be shocked. Yes?
Honest.
Honest. Good. Give me another word that describes a healthy friendship.
Trustworthy.
One more. Give me another one. Yes, ma'am.
Loyal.
Okay. These are good relationships, good friendships. Raise your hand if you ever had a bad friendship or a toxic relationship. Raise your hand. Okay. Raise your hand if that person is sitting next to you. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Don't. I'm kidding. That's a joke. Don't do that. No. The shade. Oh, my God. The shade. So what's some examples? Give me some words of a bad relationship. Give me some words to describe bad friendships that are good for you. Anybody? Fellas are quiet. One of the fellas, give me something. Bad relationship. When you're in a bad relationship with a friend, yes.
Untrustworthy.
Untrustworthy. When they're not trustworthy, good. Good. Mm-hmm. So your friends are very important. Your friends will set you up for failure or success. And you have to learn how to manage yourself and your friendships. The last point, impact of character. The impact of your character is important. Give you an example. Let's say you break the school record in basketball, 45 points, 3 games in a row, just on fire, right? And you celebrate over the weekends. And you do something you normally wouldn't do. 24 hours later, you're in the ER. Bad car wreck. And somebody else didn't survive the car wreck. All it takes is 24 hours and all that other stuff is gone. Because everybody was talking about that 45 points, 3 consecutive games in a row. Everybody was talking about where you're gonna go, what you're gonna be, what you're gonna do. And then that car wreck happened. Things are different now because of one decision. Does that make sense? Okay, the character can impact so many levels of your life. So many levels. I'll give you an example. I was actually on the phone in a grocery store just last week. And I'm talking professionally on this phone call, taking care of business. So I'm talking, and I notice the lady in the same aisle, and I didn't think anything of it because I'm working right now. I get off the phone, and I'm leaving. I walk past the lady, and the lady says, excuse me, you have some of the most professional phone etiquette and phone manners that I've ever seen in my life. And I said, well, thank you. Thank you so much. I just want to make sure that I honor my mother and my father. And the next thing she said, I was just about to say that. Someone raised you right. Your mom and dad did a fantastic job in raising you. And I said, thank you. That's from a stranger. She doesn't know me. I don't know her. So the impact of your character has so many different things that it can impact along the way. It can impact you academically. It can impact your sport. It can impact your family. There's so many different levels of character that it can impact, and it's important. One of the number one resources is point number two, your friends. They're gonna influence you and your character. So make sure that if you don't have what other people have, let's say you don't go to church Sunday and Wednesday. Maybe you guys don't have dinner at the table with mom and dad every night. Maybe you don't have a mentor to pour into you. Find one. Find someone that's already doing what you want to do in life and ask them for advice. Ask them to be your mentor. Read some books. There's mentors in books. YouTube. Find a mentor on YouTube. Study their material. Study the moves of the people that you want to aspire to be. Do we have any tennis players in here? Golf players, basketball players, okay, volleyball players, football players, basketball players. Hey, wait a minute, that kid didn't raise his hand at all. I'm kidding. All right, before we close out, is there anything else that we need to cover and discuss this morning? Anybody here planning on being a D1 athlete or a pro athlete? Wow, okay. Wow. What sport? Track, okay. Track and field. What sport?
Volleyball.
Okay.
Basketball.
Volleyball. True story. Did you know in 1995, when a young lady was extremely talented in basketball, her options were very limited? You guys are too young. You've never heard of this before. You've never heard of these words. We got next. You guys have no idea what that means. In 96, that was a campaign. That was a program. We got next. In 1997, that's when the women's NBA came into existence. Because in 95, if a woman graduated from high school to play basketball, she didn't have a whole lot of options. A lot of times they would go to overseas to play. All right. So, with that being said, questions from the audience. Oh, I know a question that somebody probably wants to ask, so I'll answer it real quickly. What happened to your arm? This is a condition called cerebral palsy, all right? So when I was born, it was a very traumatic birth. The doctors told my mom and dad that I would not survive. They didn't give me 24 hours. They gave me half of that. I wouldn't make it through the night. My birth was very traumatic. Didn't have enough oxygen to my brain. They pulled, could not get me out. Eventually, they pulled hard enough and got me out, but it damaged the brachial plexus nerve center and my spine. But I don't let that stop me. I don't. 30 years of martial arts, basketball, football, track. Oh, yeah. Odell Beckham Jr. I've been doing that my whole life. Basketball. I know what it's like, guys. I know what it's like. Yeah, give me him. Yeah, I want him. Y'all want that dude. All right, man, come on. I know what it's like to get sick last, but it's okay. Because when I cross them up and I dot the I and I put their lights out, they look at me differently. Before I close out, there were some folks that got here a little late, so I'll give you just a few little bit of bars and then I gotta run. Is that okay?
Yes.
Wait. Y'all want these bars or not?
Yes.
Yes.
All right, here we go. I'm announcing my presence with authority. There were so many that tried to ignore me. They called me Mr. Shankle. I break hearts and bent ankles. Like a suit, I too am black and intelligent. Bear witness to this unchained eloquence. From pen to paper and paper to pen, I'm turning heads like a drop-top Benz. Rocking the Johnston and Murphy as I serve the presidential. With this spectacular vernacular, I got the best bars in the building. Above their heads like a ceiling. It's all love here, so how you feeling? Victory's mine, so I speak healing. You can hear me like an echo. Money like Gordon Gekko. Haters know where they can go. I saw old moppy glow. I use my competition to mop the flow. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your time.
That's
my time.
That's about the